Okay, Google Ads lead form extensions are here. Dun dun dun. What does this mean? What are lead form extensions? How do they work? It is actually, I think, going to disrupt in a good way the game of lead generation on Google. The way it works is at the bottom, especially on mobile, I believe they're going to be more present. On mobile devices, when people search for like a local plumber, for example, there is now going to be an ad extension. An ad extension is what shows up, you know, at the bottom of your ad, in addition to the, you know, core text you have on an ad. There's going to be an extension that allows people to click a button that says something like get offer or contact now. And when they click that button, a lead form populates at the bottom of the Google ad. When you click on that button, obviously the person showing that Google ad is going to be charged the click cost, the cost per click. But you immediately get a lead, okay? So the way it works is you click on the get offer button or contact now, and the lead form opens. Now here's what's interesting. About 70% of people who make a search on Google Chrome are unknowingly logged into their Google account when they make the search. So hear me out on this. The name and phone number associated with your Google account is going to auto-populate, okay, in the lead form extension, which makes it so much easier for people to submit their information, okay? So why is this important? Well, the number one move in any industry is to help people save time. That's why Uber worked, right? Saved people time. This is going to save people time, and it is going to change the game of lead generation because it literally cuts out at least, I'd say, three steps, right? You'd have to click on the ad, you'd have to go to people's website, then you'd have to go to the contact page, and you have to press submit, then you have to wait for them to reach back out. The lead form extensions can be sent right to your phone immediately as a text message, which creates a faster response rate. Okay, meaning you're going to respond to the leads faster, and there's less steps for them to submit their information. And Google did a test and actually found about a 20% higher close rate using the lead form extensions on their ads. Okay, so we're still in the baby phases of this. I believe it was just rolled out. It's so funny. You always learn about these things while they're testing them out, right, in beta. If you're lucky to be in a market where they beta test something, you get to see kind of how Google's working on their product. I think this is going to be huge, and this is going to make things awesome for us as a digital marketing company, because it's going to make things, it's going to make it more important that your campaign is set up with, you know, with the ad showing to the right audience. So I'm excited to see how this works. If you're curious and you want to look up more information on the lead form text, the lead form extensions in Google Ads, just type it in on Google and you can see some examples of it. Search Engine Journal has a great article on, the name of it is Google Ads Officially Announces Rollout of Lead Form Extensions. Just look up that article if you're interested to learn more information. But man, we're going to test this out on our campaigns and see if it works. Especially if you're in a mobile market where a lot of your leads come from mobile devices, I would test this out like yesterday. All right. Hope you found this valuable. Leave us a comment if you have any thoughts on this or any input, and we'd love to continue the conversation. Make sure to subscribe to our channel to stay ahead of the trends as we discover all these amazing things. All right. Stay. Oh, and one more thing. Google's ultimate goal, we think, and I asked my director of PPC, what is, his name's Anthony Higman, I asked him, what does this say about where Google's going as a company, right, the lead form extensions? And he immediately went, he was like, well, they're trying to quantify the cost per lead and the quality per lead, okay? So by Google collecting this data from individuals submitting their information online, okay, they can gauge the quality of leads, okay, and they can eventually ask, hey, give us a description of your needs, and they can actually start doing artificial intelligence and data mining on what keywords pull in the highest quality leads, and they can more accurately quantify cost per lead and quality per lead, with the ultimate long-term goal of potentially charging per lead, which aligns with the push for local service ads, okay? And local service ads give you a guaranteed cost per lead, and you can get a refund if the person reaches out to you and it's not a legitimate lead, right? So our assumption is that they are looking to start the process of quantifying cost per lead so that you can actually just pay Google per lead versus per click, and per quality lead versus just per any lead, right? So that's where we think they're going, and exciting changes to come. But I think that's the master grand plan here, which came straight out of Anthony's head, and I think it's true. So let's see what happens. I love all the changes. Keeps us on our toes.